Remember, we are living in a global world or in a global economy. The best example is, let's say, with Zoom class. Zoom is based in USA and we are using, let's say, a Chinese mobile phone or a Korean mobile phone with American software with Windows 10. And we are using, let us say, an Indian company like Airtel or BSNL to communicate. So this is the example of globalization. Now, what happened during the world wars? The world had seen devastating two wars in the past. The first was in between 1914 to 1918. And the second, of course, we all know very well, it affected Manipur itself. And it ended with an atomic bomb or nuclear bomb for the first time was used in history. So world wars are devastating. We'll look at the First World War. To begin with, what you need to know in class 10 history is who actually fought the First World War. So on one side, you have the Central Powers or the Quadruple Powers. Quadruple means a group of four. Now in this group of four, you have Germany, you have the Austro-Hungarian Empire or the Empire of the Habsburgs, and then you have Bulgaria and you have the Ottoman Empire or Turkey as we know it today. So you have the Central Powers on one side, and then you have the Triple Entente. Triple means a group of three. In the beginning, there were three powers mainly, Russia, Great Britain and France. But later on, you have Italy, Romania, Japan and USA also joined. So combined, they were known as the Allied Powers. To have a rough idea, let me just show you a map. If you look at the yellow colors, these are the Allied powers. Of course, you will not see USA on this map. It will be right across the Atlantic Ocean. But this is the idea. And then you see the colors in pink. These are the Central powers. So this was a very devastating world war between 1914 to 1918. Now in this unit, we are looking at the impact or the effect on trade and economy. Now, First World War estimate is about 10 million. That is only the military or the soldiers that died. 1 million is 10 lakhs, so 10 million would be 1 crore. So about 1 crore soldiers died. And civilians would be about 7 million or let us say 70 lakhs. So this is just the human cost. In war, actually there are no winners, there are only losers. Everyone suffers. Second World War was even worse. 60 million or 6 crore overall. Out of that, how many thousands would have died in Manipur itself? Only thing why I showed you this page is you understand the human cost. That is the most important consideration for anyone. Now you also look at the other costs also. War would have destroyed so many things. The roads, bridges, factories, the towns itself. When we really compare, unlike the European countries, war did not affect North America or USA or Canada, but rather they prospered actually. Factories and the farms and the countrysides performed even better actually. So they profited from it. USA was not affected, but the other European countries, France, United Kingdom, were also affected, but they managed a little bit of an economic recovery without much difficulty. Now Germany is the problem here after First World War. First thing as a student is to note that Germany was on the losing side. Rather, all the quadruple powers or the central powers were on the losing side. And in various ways, they had so many penalties or let us say punishments given out to them. First, under the Treaty of Versailles, Germany had to make a huge payment. This was called reparations. Now this heavy reparation combined with damage which was already there throughout Germany, the political problems or the tension that was there, the Weimar Republic, this led to an economic depression. When all these things happen, governments normally they react and there's something called protectionism. Protective tariffs, these are tariffs that are enacted with the aim of protecting a domestic industry. They aim to make imported goods cost more than equivalent goods produced domestically, thereby causing sales of domestically produced goods to rise. This is a little advanced definition, but it is there in your book. You need to remember it. Protective means to protect. If you look at the picture, you would see the people under an umbrella. They are getting protected from the sun. Normally, protection starts with one. It starts with a few, only the trusted people who are inside that protection. What is a tariff then? Tariff is just a tax, an entry tax. This relates to imports mainly. Enacted means it becomes a law. It becomes formal, it becomes legal. That means if you break this, there will be some penalty, some consequence. These have the aim of protecting the domestic industry. Now look at the picture once again. What is going on here? They are saying you want to enter our umbrella, you have to pay a huge tax. So the people inside the umbrella are already protected. People from outside or the foreign goods or foreign imports cannot come in easily. I think it's similar to what's going on with this quarantine. They don't allow anyone to enter easily. And if they do also, they make them go through a very strict quarantine system. So all this carries on, especially during an extraordinary situation. So the whole point is that the domestic goods are protected and the sales of domestically produced goods begin to rise. Now protectionism is a way in which governments, or they make it a law, or they make it a policy that as a government they need to protect their local industry. So in a sense, this is a return to mercantilism. In USA itself, we will look at one example in the book. When the stock market crashed in USA in 1929, the government responded with the highest protective tariff in the USA. This is called the Smoot-Hawley Tariff Act. It's mainly a tax on imports between states. It's a regulation of foreign trade. And we are not studying US history, but here you understand is that if a great economic power like USA could also be in this position, what about the rest of the world? So in globalization, you cannot expect that if one great event happens in one part of the world, it's not affected. Let's be very clear. From this week, I think we are getting a little careless. I want us to wake up now. Are we in lockdown?
We are in lockdown.
Time to wake up now. This is the reality. What started in China, now it has affected the whole world. In 1914, 1918 also, the First World War affected the whole world. It affected the economy also. Everyone is suffering. So this has affected us now also. So this is a good example for us now during this pandemic to understand and reflect. And later on, this will not be forever. But when you grow up and you become mature and responsible people, and you learn to take certain decisions at the right time. During an extraordinary situation, this was already there in the past, and in history, it is good to understand the past so that we can apply it in the present. As they say, everyone make mistake, but you got to learn from that mistake so that you don't repeat it in future. During this pandemic or during lockdown also, everyone protects each other. Nobody wants their own people to get sick, to suffer. Protectionism is a way of that, to protect. The human cost was very high, but the other cost also has to be considered. Now during Corona, I keep going back to Corona because I have to remind you right now, I think most of us are getting careless. Yes, a lot of people died, but then the economic cost is also there. Whenever there is an extraordinary situation, now this doesn't happen all the time, by the way, so nothing to be worried, just learn from it. Production is naturally reduced. You have less goods in the market because less people are working. And now in that case, even though they wanted to work, the people were dead already because of war, or the factory was destroyed again because of the war. And even if they had produced it in the factory, there was no way to take it to the market because there is no road, no railway, no ship. This took time to repair it. Now the book says it got strangled. Literally that means they were gasping for air, struggling or fighting to survive. This was the case even among the strong economies of Europe. Germany was actually finished economically and financially after the First World War. In the past, England was the banker to world trade. After the First World War, it was no more a banker to the world trade. At that time, it used to finance world trade because it itself was a trade superpower. After the First World War, it came down. The overseas investment became almost nil. USA profited for some time, but this did not really last very, very long. The best way to understand is to look at something called the domino effect. If you look at this picture, one house has fallen, another has fallen, and the last two which are still standing is just a matter of time before they fall. So in the domino effect for world trade, everyone is affected. No one can escape it. Now USA also, they were the most powerful creditor, and they gave millions of dollars of war loan to France, to Italy, Britain and other allies. A lot of wrong choices were there. There was a boom in USA, but they did not put that money in other places. They put that money to build up their own industry. The book says there's a flight of American capital. Now this is quite natural. Businesses are all about making profit. When the whole countryside of France, Belgium is destroyed in the war, it would make sense to put it back in USA. But there is always a consequence. A worldwide situation on globalization. Nobody is safe. Let's say they produce a lot of goods, but then after the American market is full, all those goods have to be sold. You produce something to sell. How could they sell it in Europe? Everything was mostly destroyed in the war. People had no money itself. That's in turn, slowly it would lead to the great economic crash or depression of 1929. So their purchasing power is reduced, and Americans are sitting on a lot of goods, a lot of investment with no returns. So ultimately, even the big producers like USA also suffered. Now the consequences are, this will also happen. I hope it doesn't happen in the world. The warning signs are already there. Banks, normally they always handle capital or finance at a profit. So they will increase their rate so that they don't itself go bankrupt. And they are very reluctant to give out loans. This is the protectionism of the banks also. The technical word is restrictive, or to restrict credit. Credit means the loans. And this becomes a policy. Everyone, all the banks start to follow it. And ultimately, people are out of a job. They don't have any means of working to earn. Now, ultimately, when this situation happens, it also leads to price rise, inflation. So you have a double punishment for, let's say, the working class. On one side, they have no job and no money and no income. Another side, prices of goods are increasing and increasing. Now, when that happens, currency also goes down. The banks collapse. Now, in Europe itself, Romania, Bulgaria, Poland, Yugoslavia, even the rich countries, they lost their trade because their markets also collapsed. Now, the last time I went to Imphal, I was surprised also. The car which I saw in the showroom is just still in that same position since March. No one has bought that car also. The point is that even a company like Maruti Suzuki, with partnership between India and Japan, that company is affected. Now that effect will be there in India, it will go up to Japan as well. They have a big market everywhere, not just in the rich countries, in the poor countries as well. So when the poor countries in Eastern Europe, Romania, Bulgaria, Poland were affected, the other European countries, even the American countries were also affected. And we'll end this session with the most affected country, that is Germany. Firstly is the hyperinflation. Goods, or the prices of goods, became so high. And the next is unemployment. Staggering, or the effect was so bad that even to buy bread, you had to take, let us say, a whole basket, or let us say wheelbarrows, let us say thelagari, full of money to buy the basic items such as even bread. It slowly recovered, say, in about 1920s. Not because of their own, but because everyone else also came down. Now, the Great Depression also affected Germany. So, under these conditions that the Nazi party were able to come to power. Now, look at the pictures on the right and you will understand. Anyone had this much amount of money, everyone can retire and live a normal life and not do any work also. And even children started playing with it. Money became like a toy. A few important points is that the amount to be paid to the Allies was 50 million pounds. They could not even pay that, and they had to even take a loan from the USA. German government also took up more drastic measures. They restrict import of foreign goods and export of funds also. Now everyone realized that Germany also Yes, they were a little hard on them, but we must revive them also. Because ultimately in trade and business, there are no enemies. In terms of business, you can't really be enemies forever. In a larger sense of globalization, there are no enemies. There are only friends, there are only partners. So they tried to revive it through various plans, but it could not give any payments. The German president at that time, Hindenburg, he appealed or requested to the American president at that time, Hoover or Herbert Clark Hoover. So they gave a moratorium. Moratorium means a pause. It's like hitting the pause button. So for 1 year, they agreed to give some relaxation. If that was not there, Germany would have completely collapsed. Now comes the Nazi party with Adolf Hitler.
When you say Hitler to someone, it's like you're not giving them a compliment. Hitler, what does it mean? Mikho, isn't it? Mipalo. Me, Engse.
Yes, was responsible for the deaths of so many people. It is a power in intent. Literally, he shook the whole world. I'm not praising him, but in history, we have to look at what it is. How he affects history is today also. 17 July 2020, we are still talking about him. So when Hitler came to power, he said, no more payment. So this created a problem for the world. They called a conference in June 16, 1932. In this conference, they tried to have some compromise. United Kingdom, Germany, France. The place is in Switzerland, Lausanne. Now, they realized that it was impossible for Germany to resume its payments. Yes, Germany was very wrong. Especially the Belgians and the French were very angry. Because what the Germans did was, they deliberately or purposely destroyed and looted their towns, their factories, after they withdrew from the war. And they said, no, you must pay. But they could not pay. And they substituted it with a payment of 150 million pounds by redeemable bonds. It's also called callable bonds. In a way, it's like saying that I owe you some money. And also at some kind of interest. The thing about redeemable bonds is that it is redeemable. That means it can be also terminated by the issuer before it reaches the end. So there is a time limit there. Now it is up to the issuer, in this case Germany, before it reaches the end, we can finish up payment and cancel the debt. So it was reasonable and it should have worked. But then you have Hitler coming in. So they didn't pay at all during the Second World War, rather they reacted very strongly against it. Germany was also divided into West and East Germany after the Second World War. Now in 1995, Germany was united once again. That means there is no East or West Germany. Now finally they settled the loan on 3rd October 2010. So just 10 years back, all this payment has finally been paid. Let me end up this class by giving you a simple lesson that in a pandemic, in a world situation, world crisis, everyone is affected, including you and me. So don't ignore it and don't be careless about it, because the domino effect, even the strong are affected, the weak are affected. But you need to know that once it is over, it is over. The thing is that during this problem, what do you do? And as a student, you need to be very careful, very sure about what you are doing, especially not wasting time.